Mr. Klaus Peterson, Dr. Smith will see you now.
Sir.
Just right through here, sir.
Please take a seat. So, what can I help you with today?
I've been struggling to walk, and I keep getting dizziness and headaches, and I'm struggling picking up things off my phone. My hands, don't have the coordination that I should have.
How long have you been having these symptoms?
About a week and a half.
So, have you got any family history of neurological disorders?
Not that I'm aware of, no.
Okay. Are you on any regular medication at the moment?
No.
No. How often do you drink?
Most nights.
So, how many drinks would you say you have on a night out?
I do a few rainbow challenges, let's say that.
Right. Well, I can get the nurse to give you a blood test now, and I'm also going to give you a referral to the neurologist. In the meantime, I think it's probably best if you cut down the amount that you're drinking. If best, maybe cut it out until you've seen the neurologist.
Okay.
Would you like to go take a seat in the waiting room and the nurse will collect you for your blood test?
Mr. Peterson, if you'd just like to follow me up and do a quick blood test.
Well, the blood test shows that the patient is negative for hereditary ataxia and there are no genetic defects in his blood tests.
Your GP's referred you to me and I'm just going to do a couple of neurological tests today and we will see where we go from there.
Okay.
So, first of all, if I can just get you to touch my finger and then touch your nose for me. And try and touch my finger again. And back to your nose again. Okay, that's great. And then if you hold one of your hands out like this, and then if I get you to put your other hand on top of it, and then if you can turn it over, and then just keep repeating that for me. Okay, that's alright, thank you. And if you just have a quick look at my pen torch here and just follow the light there. And we're just going to take you into the corridor to have a look at how your walking is, okay? Can I just get you to walk up here, turn around, and then walk back to me, please? Just how you normally would. Okay, that's great, thank you. So looking at the symptoms that you've come here today with, and the blood tests from your GP were all clear, so we know that it's nothing genetic. The most probable diagnosis here is cerebellar ataxia, and it's probably caused by the amount you're drinking. So I would recommend to try and cut out alcohol completely, not even unlightly drink, and we'll see how it goes from there. If you have any of the symptoms still in a couple of weeks, then I'd recommend going back to your GP.
Okay, thank you.
So how's it been?
It's pretty much the same and I've completely stopped drinking.
Okay, like nothing new showed up?
No, but it's still as bad.
Okay, I think the next step would be to get you an MRI scan, so I'm going to do a referral for that.
Okay.
You'll have an appointment with the neurologist in a few weeks to discuss the results of your MRI scan.
Okay, thank you.
So I have the results of your MRI scan here, and I'm really sorry, but I don't have very good news for you. It turns out the damage you've done to your cerebellum through drinking is actually irreversible. So this is the picture of the normal brain here, and this is the scan you've had, so you can see the damage that you've done to your cerebellum here. So we don't think that the symptoms you've been having will be treated by you stopping drinking. I think the damage is a bit too far gone. So what we will be able to do is offer you some supportive treatments to help with the symptoms, but we don't have a cure for the disease at the moment.
Will I still be able to play lacrosse?
It's unlikely. If you haven't been able to play it in the past couple of weeks, I don't think it's going to be able to improve much.
Let me stop laughing.
Are you sure?